This is Destiny, the Taken King PS4 limited edition console. I had to buy this old console to try the recently released exploit. It came with firmware 2.51 out of the box. Then I updated the console to firmware 4.05, so I can run this exploit. This video will show you how to run PlayStation 4 exploit on firmware 4.05. As I made this video, there are only a small number of payloads available for the PS4. They are payloads for enabling debug mode, FTP service, and web browsing on an unactivated console. Remember, you still cannot install PKG games using these payloads, but hopefully we can experience it sooner or later. This guide applies to all PS4 consoles running firmware 4.05 only. Download the recommended files from the link in the description. Good luck and enjoy the video. This is my PlayStation 4 home screen. Let's check its firmware version by going into the settings tab. This console is still on firmware 2.51. We should update it to firmware 4.05 to try the exploit. First, let's turn off the automatic software update. Then, let's make the console stays disconnected from the internet in rest mode. Now let's download the PlayStation 4 firmware 4.05 manually. Open your web browser and go to this URL. Scroll down and search for firmware 4.05, then download it. Prepare a USB flash drive and format it as FAT32. Then create a folder named PS4. Enter PS4 folder, then create another folder named Update. Then copy the downloaded PS4 4.05 firmware to this folder. Plug the USB flash drive to the console and go to System Software Update. It will detect the 4.05 firmware. Press Next and proceed with the update. It will take a while to process. Please be patient. Now we are back at the home screen. Now the console is on firmware 4.05 and we are ready to try the exploit. Open your web browser and go to this URL. Download the latest version of PS4 exploit host. I chose the Windows version. Then open another URL and download the PS4 payloads package. Place the downloaded files anywhere on your computer. Then extract the PS4 exploit host package. Navigate to the extracted package and enter the payloads folder. Then extract the content of the payloads package to the payloads folder. And then double-click the PS4 exploit host app. Make a note of this. You must input this IP address as your console's primary DNS server. Open the PS4 network settings. Then set up the internet connection. You may use Wi-Fi or use a LAN cable. I chose LAN cable. Then choose custom. Then automatic. Do not specify the DHCP. Now you need to enter the DNS settings manually. Fill in the primary DNS with the one from the PS4 exploit host app. then press next and continue with the rest with its default settings. Now it is time to try the exploit. Click the user's guide. If done correctly, you will see the exploit menu. Just choose IDC. Now back to your computer, you will see the payload menu. Choose any payload to inject to the console. I will start with number 4, that is enabling web browser on an unactivated PS4 console. Back to your PS4. Soon after you send the payload, you will see this screen. Just choose close. Let's try using the console's internet browser. Enter any URL or keyword to test the browser. Normally, you cannot use the internet browser when you haven't activated or connecting the console to the PSN. But with this permanent PS4 web browsing enabler payload, you can surf the web freely. To inject another payload, you must reopen the user's guide. Choose Y to send another payload. This time we will press number 3, that is enabling the debug settings. Choose Close. Scroll down, and you will see a debug settings. To be honest, I don't know anything about each function, and I don't want to mess with this. Let's go back to the user's guide to try the last payload. Press Y, then press 2 for FTP payload. Now enter this IP address and port number on your favorite FTP manager. I use FlashFXP. Click Quick Connect and enter the console's FTP IP address and port number. Then press connect. It took several retries before you can successfully connect it to the console. Now you can see the internal hard drive file and folder structure. I don't want to mess with this, so I just leave it as is. Now choose end to end the payload injecting process. Press the option button on the controller, then choose close window. Now let's restart the console to see if the patch still working. There is no debug settings inside the settings tab. Now let's try running the internet browser. Since it is permanently patched, then we can still use the internet browser freely. Now you have completed the PS4 exploit tutorial. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope it helped you. Please subscribe for more upcoming videos.